Hello and welcome to Bristol Sport TV, and we've got a special edition this week. As you'll notice, we're in a slightly different venue to usual. We are actually in our pop-up store at John Lewis at Cribbs Causeway, and I'm pleased to say I've got a couple of players with me as well. Joe Joyce from Bristol Bears, Taylor Moore from Bristol City. I'm going to let you do some Christmas shopping after. So what kind of shoppers are you? I hate to say it, after all these years, a last-minute Lucy kind of Christmas Eve. Well, what are you, Taylor?
So I've got quite a big family, so it's quite hard to fit everyone in early doors. But I am a bit like you. I tend to be out on Christmas Eve grabbing a few bits and bobs.
Panic buying, that's what I tend to
exactly
do.
Exactly that.
Now, a little birdie has told me, someone who is very close to you, that Christmas present buying, it's his twin, just in case you're wondering, Christmas buying present, you tend to outsource, shall we say?
Oh, I like to get other people's opinion before I buy a present as well. I don't really trust myself when I go shopping. I haven't much patience, so yeah. I do ask before I buy, if I'm not the best.
I like that. You straw poll what you're going to get. So in terms of best and worst, best Christmas present ever, worst Christmas present, Taylor?
I'm going to have to go with the worst.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So the worst Christmas present ever was from my uncle, who 2 years ago, when I was 19 years old, decided to buy me a Spider-Man comic book. And when I asked why, his excuse was it was meant to be for my little brother, but he didn't have anything for me, so he then switched them over.
Oh, the genius of present switching.
That's... So he did laugh when I opened it, so it like, must yes. have been a joke, but for me, that's the worst.
Back to childhood. So your worst, I've been told the worst present that you've ever given, but what was the worst one you've ever received?
Mine was probably when I was a young kid. I asked for a goalkeeping jersey when I was young. I was like playing in goal. Because I wasn't
being
very good.
Mad City yeah. fan,
and then I asked if David Seaman, an Arsenal top, and I opened up the present, and it was a goalkeeper top with number 7 Perez on the back. So it didn't really make sense. So I had an outfield player's number on a goalkeeper shirt. So it didn't make sense. So in the playground, I did get bullied a little bit for
little
that.
A little bit of yeah. teasing, I suspect. Well, you've also got, of course, you travel a lot with your roommates and teammates over the Christmas period. So what's the culture for that? Is it Secret Santa? Have you got to buy you? Obviously, your roommate is Sammy. Is there's a close-knit group there?
Yeah, definitely. I think a few of us younger boys in the team are very close, although we are close with everyone. But we tend to do birthdays a lot. So 4 or 5 of us always get together and chip in and get someone a birthday present. Christmas, we haven't really discussed yet.
So you haven't got anything for Sammy just yet?
I can't tell you that on camera. Okay. No, not just yet. We'll have to talk about it, discuss it with our partners and see where we go from there.
Okay, do we see any Inner Bears Sanctum presents that are being bought?
Not really, no, but we have obviously got our Secret Santa, which we've done this morning, so I'm going to pop off in a minute and get some terrible gifts for someone in the team.
Oh, you heard it here first, but you're not going to obviously reveal
not
who.
Really,
I mean, we're joking about Christmas, but of course, as a professional sportsman, actually, it's a really busy time. You guys have got to keep your training, you've got the games. I mean, Taylor, you've got 4 games in 11 days. Such a busy fixture list.
Yeah, definitely. When I was playing back out in France, we actually had a break over the Christmas period. So coming back over to the UK is something you have to adapt to. And like you said, it is very busy and it is demanding. It's normally time that you'd enjoy spending with your family, but we get to travel and be with our teammates. But it is a fantastic time of the year for us on the pitch, but it's also fantastic for the fans that get to come to the games.
Yeah, well, they are your surrogate family, of course.
Definitely.
Well. Joyce, for you guys, slightly, not quite as mad as City's run in, but it's still busy. A game against Wasps on the 27th.
It is, yeah. And the first thing we look for is it home or away? And luckily this year we got a home fixture on Christmas on the 27th. And we have got Christmas Day off, which is good. And we're not in the Boxing Day until midday. So we have got a bit easier than the football lads.
Yeah. Well, I have heard, correct me if I'm wrong, you are hosting Christmas Day for the Joyce family this year. First time ever.
First time, cooking. Massive pressure, yeah. So, yeah, I don't know if I'm looking forward to it or not. I just want to hurry up and get it done.
Have you got a backup plan if anything goes wrong?
That's a worrying thing. I haven't, no. I've just got to back myself.
Always back yourself. So talking about the fixture list, of course, you guys, it's always a busy week, isn't it? But this weekend away at Fulham and the chance to go level with them in the table.
Definitely. I feel that we've had a few tough games already this season when we've probably dropped a few points that, looking back on, we shouldn't have. We're going into this weekend, obviously Fulham, massive team. but we believe that we can go there and get the 3 points, no problem at all.
Yeah, and barely a chance to catch your breath because you've got Millwall back at home on the Tuesday
night.
Of
course, like we were just saying before, it's busy. It's a busy time of the year.
Yeah, I mean, that's actually one of the things I was talking with Lee after the midweek fixture, where, of course, you went down away, and he was just saying, I'm looking for a response and I want to play quickly. That Huddersfield game couldn't come quickly enough.
Definitely. I think that's a great thing with the Championship as well. Sometimes you do stumble along the way and you do get a bad result, but games come thick and fast and you get that chance to put it right a few days later. And I think we did exactly that against Huddersfield at the weekend. Everyone was really disappointed after the performance and the result against West Brom, who are a top team. But we came back to Bristol, we made things right, and we came firing out the blocks, really, and 5-2. There's no better way of doing that.
Yeah, you certainly did. It was certainly a response. And, Joyce, this weekend it's back to European Challenge Cup action as you welcome Stade Francaise to Ashton Gate. You were part of the winning team over in Brive as well. I was talking to Stephen Lurtier, and he was saying that it was the best performance or best display that he's seen from the Bears since he signed.
Yeah, after when the professor went, I'd probably say it's in the top three fiends I've had in the Bristol shirt. Not many teams go to France and nail a side and get 5 points, and the way we'd done it as well was pretty special, so we enjoyed that night. But with French teams, you never know what we're going to get, so we're going to focus on ourselves this weekend. We're back at home at Ashton Gate. Also, we're a little bit disappointed we didn't get the 5 points this weekend, but at the end of the day, we're still undefeated at home. So I'll make sure we carry it into Saturday as well now.
Yeah, well, you certainly know a little bit about French teams. Of course, grew up in France.
Yeah, definitely. I spent 12 years out there, from the age of 7 to the age of 19 when I joined Bristol City. And it was a fantastic period of my life, but I now consider Bristol as my home. Yeah. And I'm glad to be back. I've had my loan spells away from the club, but kind of always had that goal to be back here. And thankfully this year I've been given the opportunity and it's going well so far.
How did the conversation go? Because if I'm correct, I heard there was, you know, conversation with your dad mainly about who you were going to represent, because you had the chance to have dual nationality.
Yeah, definitely. So I'd lived out in France for a certain amount of years, and I was entitled to take up dual nationality. And Joyce, you'll know when you're coming through the ranks at your clubs, whether that's rugby or football, you get the opportunity to go off and represent your country as well. Mm. And I had the opportunity to go off and represent France. But after having a long conversation with my dad, I just decided that I might have to wait 1 year or 2 years later, but I wanted to represent England. I felt English, although I was still living out there. And thankfully, 1 year after, I had the opportunity to do that.
You did a fantastic performance at the under-17s Europeans.
Yes, so we went off and won the first youth trophy England had won in a very long time. Played alongside some very, very good players who I still speak to now on a regular basis. And we've all gone off on different journeys, but it's nice to come across a lot of them in teams in the Championship or even in League One and League Two. During my loan spells, we all stay in touch, and that's what football's all about.
Yeah, I mean, your journey has been phenomenal, and we talk about player pathways and routes, and it hasn't been an easy route for you.
No.
and particularly choosing to represent sort of the England side, you're saying always felt English.
Yeah.
How did those loan spells go?
Yeah, so it's like you said, it's been a bit of a different journey, but everyone does go on different journeys, and I think you do come across many challenges, and especially at a young age. So I joined Bristol City when I was 19 years old. I felt that I was ready, but obviously now looking back at it three years later, I understand that I wasn't, and I needed those loan spells. I needed to go and play league football in League Two, in League One, and thankfully the clubs I was at gave me that opportunity. And like I said, it wasn't easy. You do come across some very, very tough times, but it's about sticking with it and accepting that every day you've got to challenge yourself, and having that goal to come back to Bristol City and play for Bristol City was always in the back of my mind, so it kind of kept me going. And I'm here now and enjoying my football.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's something that is shared by the sporting group, isn't it? That aspiration of player pathway and coming up right the way through the ranks. Of course, you are well known for coming right the way up. You know, Bristol born and bred, king of Southmead, if not the king of table football. We'll talk about that in a minute. But, you know, you've come right the way through the ranks. And also, similarly to Taylor, in terms of, you know, what it's like to pick your nationalities, because you represented Ireland at youth level.
Yeah, I did, yeah. Under-18s, club and schools, I played for England against Ireland. And then England 19s, and then I made the big decision in 20s to play for Ireland. I'm playing against England there. So it was very strange.
Basically, he's indecisive, is what we can gain from
that. Whoever wants me, I'm there.
And his Christmas present.
I'm available.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a strange one, but yeah, obviously I'm very proud of my family roots, which is Irish on both sides. Yeah. I'm not English-Irish, I'm Bristolian, I tell people.
Yeah. So. I don't think anyone could be in any doubt, Joyce, of that. I mean, we were just talking about loan spells, of course. You had your period with Dings as well. In terms of how much that's progressed you to being, you know, a mainstay of the first team.
Yeah, I think it's very important. Obviously, you go from the college environment where you're one of the key players to go into the professional environment where you're bottom of the pile again. So I think it's very important these first 2 years you go out and play men's rugby as much as you can. So you learn a lot of things. Obviously, a few dark arts you learn as well. You got to take a few beatings, which is good. You got to give a few out as well. So you take a lot of learnings and you go back into the professional environment on the Monday and learn off your heroes again, basically. Mm. So you got to try and do your best and just take everything you can.
Yeah, taking a few beatings. I can see your right eye shiner coming up from today's training as well. I think you maybe get some ice on that. Yeah. I mean, it has been, you know, we're in the real busy part. That December fixture period is always really big for football, and where you guys both are in the table, I hate to say all going well, but actually all of these things have been worked so hard on over the last 18 months to get to the positions we're in now.
Yeah, well, things change quick in sport, so you know, a few bad results, few results can change a lot of things. So, and it's a bit of a cliche, but it's next game mentality. So we're thinking on Stade Francais in the weekend because we're top of the European group as well. So that needs to stay the same. We're back into an easy game at Saracens the week after. So yeah, it's tough games every week in the competition we're in. So just focus on next job.
Yeah, well, I think, I mean, you talk about no easy games. I mean, talking about the London Irish, of course, London Irish were the team that came up this year. Yeah. We know there's no easy games. They're going to come out and try and bully us in the scrum. And
yeah, they're a very organised team, very physical. You see, went down to 14 men, and that galvanised them, and they made it even tougher for us. So, yeah. It's a very competitive league this year. I think it's going to be the toughest league we've had for a very long time. Yeah.
Well, you talk about very competitive. You can never take out the competition. You guys, table football. I think maybe one of those should be on the present for maybe each of the training grounds.
Well, it started when we got to the table and there was a blue team and a red team, and I saw Joe go straight for the red team, being a Bristol City fan. But yeah, you whatever it is in life, I suppose. I've even got three younger brothers. So it is very competitive, even at home, and you see that on the training pitch every day. Joe will tell you the same thing with the rugby boys. It's in you.
Yeah, I did like the fact that you were the king of table football, but Nathan Baker was standing there going, no, he's not.
I know. I kind of did it.
You did.
Yeah, so, I did it
so
at one point.
So now you're on camera and he hasn't got a microphone.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Bakes, you heard it here first.
Yeah,
he's the king.
Sorry, Bakes, it was me. Definitely.
Well, yeah, as you say, it's all healthy rivalry, and goodness me, there are some busy fixtures ahead for the weekend. Of course, you guys are away, you guys at home, but it's actually the Bristol Flyers that kick off this weekend's action. On Friday night, they take on Sheffield Sharks at the SGS Wise Arena. Actually, the second time in a week, of course, progressing to the semi-finals of the BBL Cup after beating the Sheffield Sharks away. They beat them 58-81, and their December schedule now looks packed with a two-legged semi-final against the London City Royals to squeeze in ahead of Christmas Day. Do stay across the website and all our social channels for the details on that game. Here's what Coach K had to say after booking their place in those BBL Cup semis.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great achievement to be in the semi-finals. It's something that we haven't been able to do since our first year in the league. So that's a great feeling. And as you say, we have a two-leg series against London City Royals, which we know from our group stage. But for now, we've got to concentrate in the league. We have that first game at home against Sheffield. And, you know, they have some guys with pride out there. They have some pros with a lot of experience. And they will not be certainly happy about this loss. So we've got to make sure we concentrate this week on the league games. And we cannot think too far ahead.
So as we said, the weekend kicks off with the BBL starting proper at that game against the Sheffield Sharks on Friday night. Tip off at 7:30 with an away trip to Surrey Scorchers. Less than 24 hours later, they travel there on Saturday for a 7:00 tip-off. Just a few tickets left online, so make sure you head online to get the tickets, remaining ones for Friday night's game. Well, it was a tough weekend away for our women's team as the City women suffered a heavy defeat against Arsenal. But the women now fully focusing on Birmingham at home at the Stoke Gifford Stadium on Sunday afternoon, 3:00. Head online for tickets. Support's going to be crucial for that one, and a win very much the focus for Oxterby's players.
Obviously, we can't dwell on it. You know, it's happened now. They're a good side, you know, that's why they're so successful. They want to win Champions Leagues, they want to win the league, so we've got to expect to come up against tough opposition. They're going to be really ruthless if we're not at our best. We weren't our best at all and we can't dwell on it now. We need to move on. There are things we can work on this week to rectify, and that's what we're doing. We're more motivated than ever now to make sure that, you know, we put in a performance that we can be proud of on Sunday and get the result. Something that we need to look at in terms of what we can do better as a team. There's definitely things we can tighten up, obviously, but like I said, we cannot dwell on it that much because, you know, there is a massive gap between us and the teams right at the top, but it's not an excuse either. You know we need to be better.
Well, meanwhile, Bristol Bears women, they slipped to a 15-12 defeat away at Six Ways last Sunday, but they will be back in action at Shaftesbury Park on Saturday with a 12 noon kickoff against Gloucester Hartbury. Of course, teams that you're familiar with, and Tom, part of the coaching team for the women.
Yeah, he is, yeah. So Tom Lindsay, he's up to date what's going on. Obviously, Jordan Crane used to coach him as well. But he was saying earlier on, actually, after defeat, no better way than getting back at home against a local rival. So they're looking forward to it, I've been told.
Yeah. Well, fingers crossed that they both women's teams have a fantastic performance this weekend. Guys, best of luck for your trips away and at home. Thanks very much for stopping by. I'll let you get on with your Christmas shopping. You can run around the store quickly and maybe do a few not-so-panicked buys. The pop-up store is going to be here until Christmas Eve, so you've got plenty of time to come on down and check it out, with player appearances featuring in the countdown to Christmas. Have a good weekend at Bristol Sport.